Now, lesson 44, dispersion of light by prism. This side is air, a rarer medium, refractive index mu 1 is 1. On this side of the prism, again air, rarer medium, refractive index mu 1, 1. A, B, C is a glass prism. To the side PB, this line, and this line is the normal. This PQ is an incident ray. PQ, a narrow beam of white light consisting of the seven colors, violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange, red. Now, each of these seven colors, each color has its characteristic wavelength. Means this wavelength is different for different colors. Now, angle of incidence I is same for all the colors. This consists of all the colors called white light. So, I is same. Because they are refracted at Q at different angles of refraction, because their speeds are different in a glass medium. The violet light bends like this. This is the path along which the red light travels. So this angle of refraction is the angle of refraction for violet. This is the angle of refraction for red. Now, angle of refraction at Q is different for different colors. It is minimum for violet. You can see this is the refracted ray for violet. This is the normal. So this is the angle of refraction due to violet. This is the refracted ray for red. So from the normal, this is the angle of refraction for red. So it is minimum for violet and maximum for red, R. At Q, sin I by sin R. Sin I by sin R, either this or this, I am writing in general, is mu of this medium by mu of this medium, that is mu 2 by mu 1, this is I have taken as mu, this is 1, therefore mu. Now, look, this is a fraction. If R is less, then the value of sin R, the value of sin R is less, and this is a fraction. If the value in the denominator decreases, the value of the fraction increases. This value increases, that is, mu increases. Implies, if R decreases, sin I by sin R, its value is more. So, R is least for violet. So, sin R is least for violet. Therefore, this by this, that is, refractive index for violet is maximum. Refractive index of violet is greater than refractive index of red. Now, in a prism, we have already derived deviation. In a prism, we already have derived delta is equal to A times mu minus 1, where A is the angle of the prism, mu is the refractive index of the prism. Since mu is different, as explained here, because for all colors I is same, R is different. So different R will give you different value of sin R. So this value will be different for different colors. That is, mu will be different for different colors, being maximum for violet and minimum for red. So we know delta is equal to A times mu minus 1. So, delta due to violet, deviation due to violet, A remains same, refractive index of violet minus 1. Delta due to R, red, A times mu R minus 1. Now, from here, delta V, the value of delta V is more than the value of delta R. So, this angle minus this angle, delta V minus delta R is called angular dispersion. Now, let us put their values. For delta V, I write this. For delta R, I write this. Take A common, I am left with this. 1 1 cancels, so I am left with delta V minus delta R is equal to A times mu V minus mu R, refractive index of violet minus refractive index of red. Now, this is a number, number minus number is a number, number into angle is an angle, so delta V minus delta R is an angle. Which is that angle? Oh, this angle. Which is that angle? Now, which is that angle? If you produce like this, this is the angle. This is that angle. Delta V minus delta R means all the colors, seven colors are arranged from here to here. V, I, B, G, Y, O, R. Now, now let delta Y is equal to deviation for yellow color, which is called the mean color. Why it is called mean color? I will just explain right now. So, using the same expression, delta is equal to A times mu minus 1 for yellow color, delta yellow is equal to A times refractive index of due to yellow minus 1. Now, this divided by this, that is this divided by this, is written as omega, is called dispersive power. It is defined as the ratio of this angle divided by this angle. So for this I substitute here, for this I substitute this here, a cancels, so I am left with this. This is a number, number minus number is a number, this is a number, number minus one is a number, number divided by a number, so it is just a number. Now why yellow is called the mean color? Why yellow is called the mean color? Now actually the wavelength of lambda is between 625 nanometer to 740 nanometer. Wavelength of yellow is between 565 nanometer to 590 nanometer, and wavelength of violet is between 380 nanometer to 450 nanometer. So if you look at this plus this divided by 2 is nearly equal to this, means the wavelength of yellow lies in between the wavelength of red and violet. Therefore yellow is called the mean color, and 1 nanometer is equal to 10 to the power minus 9 meter.